How many ways can we use to create this groove? This was a case study submitted by Kayo. Thank you for this example. Kayo specifically wanted the base face of the groove to be an offset of the outside face of the ring. In other words, these two faces need to be concentric with each other. The side walls of the groove need to be flat and parallel to the plane of the groove. I provided a link for you to download the starting model. This will simply be a revolve of an arc. For the sake of clarity, I will not be cutting out the inner portion of the ring. In the first method, I'm going to create a split face that defines these two edges of the groove. Start a sketch on the front plane. Draw a rectangle centered on the origin. Delete the horizontal constraint. Adjust the angle of the rectangle. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. And select the sketch as a splitting tool. With this split face, we can perform an offset face. Go to Modify, Offset Face. And offset this by the required amount. When the offset face is done, it is hard to tell if this new face is concentric with the outside face. To check, we can begin a sketch on the front or right plane. Use the intersect command to create a line of intersection between the sketch plane and this face. If we click on this line and look at the bottom right-hand corner, we can see that this is an arc. So this face is indeed concentric with the outer face of the ring. Let's check to see if the side walls are flat. If we right-click on the face, we do not see an option to sketch. So it is not flat. This is because the offset happens in a way that is normal to the original spherical face. Let's keep this in mind and move on to the next method. Let's try the pipe command. For this, we will need a single split line. For the sketch, draw a straight line centered on the origin. Go to Create, Pipe. Select the split line as a path. For some reason, when I performed the split face, the resultant split line consisted of two segments. You can control select to add the other segment, but I would advise against that. After some testing, I found that this actually confuses the pipe command and creates an uneven cut. So just select one segment for the moment. Select the square cross section. Adjust the section size. Confirm and repeat the command to perform the pipe for the next segment. you can see that the cut is performed in a way that the depth is only half of the width of the square, while the width of the cut takes a full width of the square. So this limits how much you can adjust the groove dimensions. Another consequence of this method is that this produces a face that is actually cylindrical in nature. If we click on this face, the readout produces a radius. If we create an intersect, as in the previous method, this would be a straight line. If we right-click on the side walls, we can see that they are flat. This is not surprising, since we are cutting with a square cross-section. So in order to create the final shape that we need, we will somehow need to combine the properties of the offset face and the pipe commands. One way of doing this is to use a replace face command. We shall keep the pipe command as it is. Roll the timeline back to the point before the split face. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Select this face of the ring and adjust the offset. This creates a surface body that is an offset from the original ring face. This will represent the base face of the groove that we need. Roll the timeline forward. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify, Replace Face. The source face is a face that we need to replace. So select this face of the groove that was created using the pipe command. The target face is a face that we want to use to replace the source face. So select the new face. If we click on this face, we no longer see a radius. So this means that it is spherical. Let's explore another method that involves a thickened cut. We shall start from the point with a single split line. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Root. Click on these two edges and set Type to Normal. Adjust the distance inwards based on the required groove depth. With this, we have created a ring-like surface body. You can think of this as a mid-plane of the groove. Go to Create, Thicken. Select the surface body and adjust the distance. Set the operation to cut. Clicking on this surface shows that this face is cylindrical. Right-clicking on this face shows that this is flat. So basically, this produces the same result as a pipe command. As in the previous method, we can use a replace face to resolve this. As an alternative, we could also have created an offset surface to split the ring body into two. During the thickened cut, we can control the cut to be performed only on the outside body. Thereafter, we will need to combine the bodies. For the next method, I will attempt to use a swept cut. We will start from the point just after the single split line. Let's begin a sketch on the front plane to sketch our sweep profile. Project this split line. Convert this to a center line. I want to build a profile that is larger than required, so we want to extend this projected line beyond the body. If we hover over this point, we can see the projected constraint appear. Select the constraint and delete. We are now free to extend this line. The line is still locked onto the split line by this constraint. Draw a circle that represents the offset required. Draw a straight line perpendicular to the center line, followed by another line perpendicular to this line. Begin the mirror command. The center line is automatically selected as a mirror line. Mirror these two lines. Go to Create, Sweep. Select these two profiles. And select the split line as a path. Click on the base face to check that it is spherical. Right-click on the side walls to make sure that they are flat. Alternatively, we can use the same profile to perform a revolve. For the revolve axis, we can draw a line perpendicular to the split line. For the last method, let's attempt to use a boundary fill command. Using the sketch from the very first example, activate the Surface tab. Use this sketch to perform a surface extrude. Extrude this symmetrically beyond the extent of the ring. Go to Create, Offset. And create a surface offset from this face. The aim here is to use these surface bodies to define the groove region. If we highlight the offset surface body, you can see that it does not fully cut the solid body. We will need to extend this. Go to Modify, Extend. And extend these two edges naturally. Go to Create, Boundary Fill. The operation will calculate the resulting intersecting volumes and present cells for selection. Click on the select box for cells. We want to select every single cell except for the region that defines the groove. Unfortunately, the checkbox in question overlaps with another checkbox. We can only check on a cell that we can see and look at the final result. This can be a bit of a hit and miss. If you fail, try selecting the bodies in a different order and repeat the selection. I'm sure that there are other viable methods that I have not gone through here. Feel free to leave a comment below.